said I was in my early 40s with a lot of life before me when a moment came that stopped me on a dime. I spent most of the next days looking at the x-rays, talking about the options and talking about sweet time. I asked him when it sank in that this might really be the real end. How's it hit you when you get that kind of news? Man, what'd you do? And he said, I went skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a bull named Blue Manchu, and I looked deeper and I spoke sweeter and I gave forgiveness I've been denying. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like you were dying. He said, I was finally the husband that most of the time I wasn't, and I became a friend a friend would like to have. And all of a sudden going fishing wasn't such an imposition, and I went three times that year I lost my dad. Well, I finally read the good book and I took a good long hard look at what I'd do if I could do it all again. I went skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a bull named Blue Manchu, and I looked deeper and I spoke sweeter and I gave forgiveness I've been denying. And he said, someday I hope you live like you were dying. Like tomorrow was a gift and you got eternity to think about what you do with it. What did you do with it? What did I do with it? What would I do with it? Skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a bull named Blue Manchu, and I loved deeper and I spoke sweeter and I watched an eagle as it was flying. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like you were dying. 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 To live like you were dying.
gonna snow. By now I should be used to the cold. Mid-February shouldn't be so scary. It was only December. I still remember the presents, the tree.
My
blowing on my face, sidewalk flying beneath my bike. A 5-year-old's first taste of what freedom's really like. He was running right beside me, his hand holding on the sea. I took a deep breath and hollered as I headed for the street. You can let go now, Daddy. You can let go. Oh, I think I'm ready to do this on my own. It's still a little bit scary, but I want you to know I'll be okay now, Daddy. You can let go. I was standing at the altar between the two loves of my life. To one I'd been a daughter, to one I soon would be a wife. When the preacher asked who gives this woman, Daddy's eyes filled up with tears. He kept holding tightly to my arm till I whispered in his ear, you can let go now, Daddy. You can let go. Oh, I think I'm ready to do this on my own. It still feels a little bit scary, but I want you to know I'll be okay now, Daddy. You can let go. It was killing me to see the strongest man I ever knew wasting away to nothing in that hospital room. You know he's only hanging on for you. That's what the night nurse said. My voice and heart were breaking as I crawled up in his bed and said, you can let go now, Daddy. You can let go. Your little girl is ready to do this on my own. It's gonna be a little bit scary, but I want you to know I'll be okay now, Daddy. You can let go. You can let go.